just to get in God's show. You don't have to have titles just to get in God's show. God will take you for who you are. He don't need no superstar. He wants you to be willing to do his way and to do his will.
Come on, brother.
Because you don't have to be a star to be in God's show. When we look at this scripture here, God was given an illustration of water. See, water represents life. God is about to give you everlasting life. The life of more abundantly. God is about to take care of you. He said, everyone who drink this water from the well will thirst again. But the water I give you, well, you never be thirsty.
Hallelujah.
And we went to say, obey your thirst, and God will quench your thirst. God is better than water, honey. He's better than Sprite. He's better than your Pepsi that you drink. God will quench your thirst that you will never thirst again. God said, who goes who hunger and thirst after righteousness? The shall be saved. You got to put a hunger and thirst in your salvation. I don't care if you're a whoremonger. I don't care if you broke, busted, and disgusted. I don't care if you're a prostitute off the street. You don't have to be a star, baby, to be in God's show.
That's right.
God can use you for who you are. You don't have to be a superstar. The songwriter say, rejected and hurted. How many of y'all been here rejected and hurted? Oh, feel like all hell is breaking loose in your life. Oh, but God said, I want you for who you are.
Amen.
I can use you. I can use you as my vessel. You don't have to be a bishop. I don't have to rub shoulders with the first lady. I don't have to rub shoulders with the bishop or the apostle just to be in God's show. God can use me for who I am. I don't know who I'm talking to. God is about to use you. All you got to do is repent and give over to his will and drink from the well that will never go dry.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
You will never be thirsty again, saints. This be the best drink that you ever had. I ain't talking about no Cavassier. I ain't talking about no Hennessy. I ain't talking about no Jack Daniel. I'm talking about the living water that will spring out of the inside. You will never thirst again. God wants to use anybody and everybody. He don't care who you are. You can be from the uttermost to the guttermost. If God want to use you, he can use you, honey.
Oh, Jesus.
What are you waiting for? You don't have to be a star. Come to God as you are. Come with an open heart. Come and willing to receive. You got to have an open heart, willing to receive this blessing from God. Because God said this. Did he well, drop down to the verse? He said, woman, saying unto him, sir, I perceive that that all the prophet. You know, because she knew God had to be a prophet to know that she had five men and then married and fooled with another man and then he hurts. She was a rough woman.
Yeah.
She did everything that she thought she could do. She back then was accustomed. You weren't supposed to be married more than three times. She was married five times. And was living in the house with another man that didn't belong to her. But God said, I still want to give you living water.
Jesus.
I want to give you a drink. When you drink from this cup, Sister Chris, you'll never thirst again.
Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
That'd be the last cup you will ever need.
Jesus.
I ain't talking about no Folgers in your cup. I'm talking about the living water. But some of y'all do need to wake up and smell the coffee before it's everlasting too late. But God is soon to come back. And we worried about being a superstar. You better come as you are.
That's right.
I don't care if you broke, busted, disgusted, rejected, and hurted, beat down, dragged down. You better come to Christ. You better drink up this water before it's everlasting too late. What water I'm talking about? I'm talking about the living water. I'm talking about that living water. Then Jesus said unto the woman, believe me that the hour has come, that you should neither in this mountain, nor yet at Jerusalem worship the Father. Ye worship ye not what we know. What we worship for salvation is of the Jews. So they thought salvation was just unto the Jews. But salvation is to everybody. It's for to the Jews and the Gentiles. Then but he said about the hour coming, that is now is, when that the true worshipers shall worship. The Father is spirit and in truth.
Amen.
Ask him, honey, that we're going to worship the Father in the spirit and in truth.
Amen. That's right.
We need to be saved. If you ain't saved, you better get saved. The hour is getting late. God is trying to give you a warning. He's trying to tell you, he'll take you for who you are. All you got to do is repent and be baptized, filled with the gift of the Holy Ghost, present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, who is your reasonable servant, and drink from the cup, whether you'll never thirst again.
My God, yes, Lord.
Some of y'all drinking from the wrong cup.
Tell it.
That's why you're messed up. You're drinking from the wrong cup. Instead of drinking from the cup of Jesus, you want to drink from the cup of Hennessy. Some of y'all still drinking deuce beers up in here. Some of y'all still drinking alcohol and still smoking cigarettes. But God told me to tell you, you better pick that away. Pick the excuse card away. You ain't got to be no superstar. I'm going to take you for who you are. All you got to do is come with an open heart and drink from the cup of the living water.
Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord.
And you will never thirst again.
Glory, Jesus.
The water will spring up in you. Oh, and begin to bear fruit. Oh, when you drink from the living water.
Yes,
Lord. Oh, boy, you need the Holy Spirit to make it. I don't care who told you. Baptized in Jesus' name is good, but unless you have the Holy Spirit, you will not enter in.
Yes.
You got to have that living water in order to make it through. And you can't get around none of this. You must come through the door. You must come through the door. That's the only way into heaven. I don't care who teach what. Who teach what. That's the only way into heaven. Because if you don't have that living water, this is what we're going to be doing. Jesus, let me in. The door's going to be shut. You better walk through that door while it's open. You better get that living water while it's open.
That's right.
You better get that living water while the spring, while the well is springing forth. All this water. It's free, honey. This is a free gift. You don't have to pay for this. This is his top shelf. You ain't got to pay for this top
Jesus.
Shelf. Oh, you be drunk with the spirit.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. That's kind of drunk it is.
God is warning us. He's talking to us.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, some people get it misunderstood that you got to be a certain status or you got to be a certain person in order to do what you got to do. God can use anybody.
Yes.
God can use young people. He can use old people. Oh, he tells us in the scripture that no man despises you because God can use you. He'll teach you who you are. Oh, you might have slipped. You might have did some things wrong in your life. But God is able to forgive you, honey. He's able to forgive you of all sins. I said blasphemy against the Holy Spirit and self-murder. Because if you kill yourself, how you ask God for forgiveness? You don't have to be a star, twin, to be in God's show.
Amen.
You ain't got to be no superstar. You ain't got to be Michael Jordan. You ain't got to be LeBron James. When you drink that water, you're going to be better than him. When you drink from that living water. When you drink from the water of that fountain that will never go dry.
See,
the Samaritan woman asked Jesus, if you read the scripture, she asked Jesus, is you better than my father Jacob, who drunk from this well? Who him and his family drunk from this well? But she didn't understand who she was talking to. She was talking to the master.
Oh, Jesus, yes.
She was talking to I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last, the everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace, the mighty God, the Al Shaddai, the more than enough.
Yes, Lord.
He said, if you knew who I was, of the gift of God, you would ask me for a drink of water, the water that will never run dry, and you'll never thirst again, the living water. Oh, that's what she asked him, Sister Chris. She asked him, is you better than my father Jacob, who drunk from this water, from this well? That's why it's called Jacob's well. She asked him, but she didn't know who she was talking to. Oh, she didn't know who she was dealing with. Oh, she was dealing with a bad man. She was dealing with the superstar. She was dealing with the owl. from God. He was dealing with Jesus Christ, the Son of God, the living water. Oh, that's who she was dealing with. Oh, she was dealing with a man when all hell breaking loose in your life. He would give you peace beyond man's understanding. He would give you peace in the midst of a storm. That's who she was dealing with.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Glory. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Oh, she was dealing with a man of God who's immutable. He cannot lie, he won't change. If God said it, honey, you best believe it. If he said he's going to give you money, it's coming.
That's right. Amen.
You better stand on his word.
He never lied.
Man will lie to you all the time.
Yes.
Honey, you look good. Oh, you so sexy. I could be lying to you, but Jesus Christ will never lie. And he cannot change. You know how you get heavy so-called friends and wishy-washy? I'm always changing on you. One day your friend, one day you get smart with them, one day they don't want to talk to you. God never changes.
That's right. Go ahead and preach, Elder. You better preach.
He'll stick closer to you than any friend and than any brother.
That's right.
Come on. Thank
you. We're talking about the living water, First Lady. The living water. She didn't know who she was dealing with. She didn't know who she was dealing with. She was dealing with the man that rose Lazarus from the dead. After 3 days, he was in his grave stinking and gone. But God said, come forth. And he had to come forth.
Yes, Lord.
Because all power is in the hands of the Lord.
Yeah.
All power is in his hands. But she didn't know. But God said, you knew who I was. The gift, the free gift of God. Free. Free 99. Free. Ain't gonna cost you a dime. Salvation is free. But it's gonna cost you something to keep it.
My God. Yes, Lord.
It's gonna cost you to keep it.
Thank you, Lord.
It costs you to keep the salvation. Romans 12:1 says, present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, who is your reasonable servant. We serve a reasonable God. We serve a just God. If he did nothing else for me first, then he woke me up this morning.
That's right. Yeah. Amen. You too, Elder.
Brother Isaac, that's reasonable enough.
That's it. That's
if I ain't got a dime in my pocket, he woke me up this morning.
Yeah.
That's reasonable enough.
What a person.
Yes, sir.
When we be traveling up the dangerous highway, he keep us. That's reasonable enough.
Thank you, Lord.
You don't have to be a star to be in God's show.
Oh, Jesus.
God will take you for who you are. He'll use you for who you are.
Thank you, Lord.
You can be a wretch undone. You can be a prostitute. You can be a drug dealer, drug addict. You can be an alcoholic. You can be addicted to all types of drugs. God can use you for who you are.
Yes.
I don't care who you are here today. God wants you to be used for his service.
Yes, yes, Lord.
I don't care who you are. If you want to make it to heaven, you got to drink from this water. It's the living water of God. You got to drink from it. Because God is soon to come back.
Amen.
Please don't let him catch you with your work undone.
Amen.
Because he's going to say, depart from me, you workers of iniquity.
My God.
What are you saying, Elder? You work, you've been practicing sin all your life. So sin you practice and hell you will get. But if you prepare yourself to meet the King.
Yes.
Because heaven is a place for prepared people. He said, I got many rooms that's prepared. Do you got your reservation for your room?
Oh, yes, yes, yes.
Oh, you for.